So I thought I'd do a bit more XG, some more XG, simply because we've got some positive feedback on those videos. But it's important to talk to you about when it doesn't work, when things look odd, and sort of what to do about it and how you should discount that information. So yeah, let me talk about that in this video. Please like and comment on the video below. That will allow me to produce better quality videos and more of them in the future. So yeah, I'm going to read out some of the XG scores and the actual scores from the last round of the Premiership. So if we look at Man City against West Ham, I had to think about that for a second then, the XG was 2.47 to City and 0.48 to West Ham. And the score ended 2-1. So you can see the City match was very similar to the match that City had against Southampton. And West Ham went out to defend, they took the lead, and then City came back and won. Similar sort of style to the way that it happened at Southampton. Certainly in terms of the way the match developed. And I thought it was interesting because you could see that, you know, there was a very, very tiny gap between Southampton and City. But there was a much bigger gap between City and West Ham. But nonetheless, the XG was a fairly accurate reflection. It sort of said 2.5 to 0.5 goals, and it ended up 2-1. After that match, or was it before? I can't remember. We had Bournemouth and Southampton, and if you look at that match, it ended at 1.12 versus 1.01 in expected goals, and the match ended 1-1. Bournemouth edged the first half, Southampton edged the second, and they sort of cancelled each other out. And that was how the match ended. So both those matches went pretty much exactly the way that you'd expect if you were following XG and looking at the match as it went forward. But as I've said 1,000 times before, sometimes football doesn't work like that. And you end up in this situation where there's a big differential between what you see on the pitch and what the actual final score is. Sometimes you just sort of think, how did that happen? And we actually had two great examples of that this weekend, where we had Brighton against Liverpool, and the XG was 167 against 196. So 167 to Brighton, 196 to Liverpool, and it ended up 5-1 to Liverpool. So big variation there. And then we had the Arsenal United match, where, in fact, Arsenal had an XG of 4.55 against United's 2.11, and it ended up 1-3 against Arsenal. So Arsenal really should have won that match. There is no way that they should have lost 3-1, but they did. That is football in a nutshell. Even though, you know, you probably, and I probably would have if I was trading the match, probably would have lent on Arsenal a fair bit during that match, and I wouldn't have got a result. But it didn't really matter because you're not focused on that one particular match. It's how you perform over a period of time. But the thing that the stat was telling you during the Arsenal and Man United game is that there were going to be goals. And especially as United were in the lead, Arsenal would have wanted to try and get back into that match at some point. And they would have reached a point where they just thought, well, we've got nothing to lose now. And they would have attacked a bit more. And then that would have probably opened the door for United to go and score. So, you know, often you will get this. You will get some matches that look and feel exactly the way that they played out, and some matches where that just doesn't happen. But the significance of this is that, you know, after seeing the Arsenal United performance, I wouldn't downgrade Arsenal in any way whatsoever, despite the fact that they won 3-1. If you were just looking at the scorelines and you listed all of the scorelines of each individual team, and you looked at the form lines and joined them together, then, you know, a couple of 3-1 losses at home would start getting you marking them down. But the fact is that Arsenal had plenty of shots, plenty of good quality shots, and they should have scored, but they didn't. Now, if that persists over 5 matches or more, then there probably is something going wrong there. But over the fact that they just had one bad result doesn't mean that you should mark down expectations for the next game. Because by looking at the XG, you can see that they generated a lot of chances, they just didn't take them. So as a consequence, you wouldn't downgrade that at any particular point. So yeah, you can use that to your advantage. Rather than just looking at the plain results, use XG to dig a little bit underneath and get a better feel for it. So when I compile my ratings for the next match, I'm not going to be looking at goals. I will, obviously, but I'm going to be more focused on the chances that were created and what the scoreline should have been. So I mean, really, technically speaking, it should have been 4 or 5-2 to Arsenal based upon the number of chances that were created, and it didn't turn out that way at all. But even if you're in the match, the XG was telling you that there were going to be loads of goals. It was an open match that was creating lots of opportunities. And they're pretty similar for the Brighton and Liverpool match. Apart from, obviously, Liverpool took their chances and they've got some good finishers, and Brighton didn't. But Brighton would have probably lost anyway, but not by the margin that they did. So again, you know, if you're looking at Brighton, it's a thumping home defeat for Brighton. But technically speaking, it's not that bad. So, you know, you wouldn't go to the Amex Stadium. I almost said the Goldstone Ground then. You wouldn't go to the Amex Stadium or the arena. I don't know what they call it. I know it's Amex something. And you wouldn't expect to go there and win 5-1 necessarily, because, you know, I hate to use the word unlucky, but Arsenal and Brighton were unlucky in those terms. But if it continues for 5 matches, or they get a string of results like that, and where the, you know, that tells you that there's a problem with their finishing. And maybe they just came up against a much better defence. So De Gea had an absolute stormer at the Emirates against Arsenal for United. And that was probably a massive deciding factor in that particular game. But will he be able to do that for every game for the rest of the season? Probably not. But, you know, there's no doubt there's a little bit of adjustment to be made there in terms of the way that United are playing the season. Because they do seem to be able to dig out results this season that they couldn't last season. That's something that is quite notable so far. So anyhow, you've got some good examples there and some bad examples. And really, when you're looking at future matches and the way that teams are performing, it's more important to look underneath that to understand how it's going to play out. So I wouldn't downgrade Brighton or Arsenal too badly, despite those sort of heavy defeats, because they actually didn't play too badly. And in the other matches, they pretty much matched exactly what went on within that match. So anyhow, set your expectations according to the underlying metrics, not just the result.